大家好，我是 Stella，
我是乌龙。我们今天要问的是练习手册第325课，我自以为看见的一切不过反映了我的观念。 Lesson 325 All things I think I see reflect ideas。 让我们先来唱吧。
我自以为看见的一切不过反映了我的观念。 All things I see reflect ideas。 我自以为看见的一切不过反映了我的观念。 All things I see reflect ideas。这是救恩的要诀，我所见的一切反映出我心灵的运作方式，而它又源自我心目中的欲望与需求。 This is salvation's keynote. What I see reflects a process in my mind, which starts with my idea of what I want. 心灵先从那儿营造出自己想要的意象，赋予它某种价值，然后千方百计地把它召回来。 From there, the mind makes up an image of the thing the mind desires, judges valuable, and therefore seeks to find. 这些意象必会向外投射成有形之物，你不仅亲眼看到它还栩栩如生，你会保护它犹如自己的眼瞳。These images are then projected outward, looked upon, esteemed as real, and guarded as one's own. 神志不清的愿望就这样形成了一个神志不清的世界。From insane wishes comes an insane world. 评判的心也会引来一个充满罪罚的世界。From judgment comes a world condemned. 然而宽恕之念所带来的这是一个祥和的世界，他会仁慈看待上主之子，给他一个安歇之地，供他出发之前略作休息，同时协助弟兄们一块儿前行，一起找到通往天堂及上主之路。 And from forgiving thoughts, a gentle world comes forth with mercy for the Holy Son of God to offer him a kindly home where he can rest a while before he journeys on and help his brothers walk ahead with him and find the way to heaven and to God. 天父，你的观念反映出真理之境，我的观念只要一离开你的圣念就会制造梦境。 Our Father, your ideas reflect the truth and mine apart from yours but make up dreams. 愿我只着眼于你圣念的倒影，因为唯独你的圣念才能晋升于真理之力。 Let me behold what only yours reflect for yours and yours alone establish truth. 以下是最雄的示意。 You are blessed beings indeed. 你是有福之人。 I am that one that you know as Jesus. And of course, this is the great challenge to the things that you are taught about your world, that it is objective and it is happening to you. It is not coming from you. 我是你所知的 JC, 显然本科的观念挑战着你一直以来被教育的有关世界的观念，即世界是客观存在的事实，且是发生在你身上的事，而不是源自于你。Anybody that is still in the battleground does not believe this lesson, and many of you will not believe this lesson. The only way for you to believe this lesson is to practice it.
真正活在战场中的人是不会相信本科的观念的，你们有很多人也不相信本科的观念，唯一让你能够相信这个观念的方式就是去练习它。
You practice
Changing your mind about something and that something will reflect the change in your mind that you have chosen to make. If this was an objective world, that would not happen.
你练习改变自己对某件事情的看法，而那件事情将会反映出你决定改变的想法。如果世界是客观存在的事实，那种反应就不会发生。
If this was an objective world, your thought could not make any difference whatsoever. If this was an objective world, you would be a victim.
如果世界是客观存在的事实，你的念头就不可能产生任何作用。如果世界是客观存在的事实，你就是一位受害者。
But you are not a victim. You are a creator. You are made in the image of God, and we must remind you day after day that you are made in the image of God, and what you find in your world reflects something that you want.
但你不是一位受害者，而是创造者。你是依照上主的形象塑造。我们必须日复一日的提醒你，你是依照上主的形象塑造。你在世界所看到的事情反映出你内心想要的经验。
If you look upon death and destruction and keep choosing to look upon death and destruction, we will give you an example.
如果你着眼于死亡和毁灭，且不断着眼于死亡和毁灭。
For example, if you see a disaster on your news station and you turn it on and you look at it and you watch it and you wring your hands in honor and then you tune in again later to see how it's going, you are choosing to indulge in that.
比如说你在新闻节目中看到一个灾难，你打开这个节目并且观看它，你因恐惧而焦急担忧，然后晚一点时你又再打开电视看看情况如何，这表示你选择沉浸在那件事情中。
If you do as we have askedAnd get rid of your television sets and choose only loving, kind, informative, educational, uplifting, inspiring entertainment, you will not be indulging in that.
如果你依照我们的建议去做，把电视机搬走，只选择有爱的、仁慈的、提供有用讯息的、有教育意义的、提振人心的、有启发性的娱乐，你就不会沉浸在那些事情上。
But if you keep looking at the car accident as you drive by, you are choosing that and you will get more that.
如果你不断看着你开车时经过的车祸现场，你就是在选择那件事，那么你就会得到更多那样的经验。
And so we encourage you to practice this lesson with diligence and ask yourself, What am I seeking in the world? Am I seeking peace, joy, creativity, and self-realization?
所以我们鼓励你勤加练习这一课，并且问问自己，我正在世界中寻找什么？我是在寻求平安、喜悦、创造力和自我实现。
Or am I seeking arguments, frustrations, wars, bad relationships, and unhealthy food?What am I seeking? Those things represent ideas that I have, that I bring into manifestation by my desire for them.
或是寻找争执、挫折、战争、负面的关系、不健康的食物，我所寻求的那些东西反映出我所抱持的观念，而我透过我对那些事情的渴望而将我的观念显化为事实。
Look at what you desire. Look at what's coming to you. The process of projection is a powerful one.
请看看你的渴望是什么，看看来到你眼前的是什么，投射的过程是一个力量强大的机制。
Your entire world is made by process of projection. Once the mind has cleared, the projector will only project good things. be the change that you want to see the world, and your projector will begin to project good things.
你的整个世界都是由投射的过程所照出来的，你的心灵一旦进化，投射机就只会投射出美好的事物。你希望看到世界作何改变，你自己要先变成那样。如此一来，你的投射机便会开始投射出美好的事物。
I am that one that you know as Jesus, and I will speak to you again tomorrow. 我是你所知的 JC, 我们明天再会。
让我们再来唱一次吧。
我自以为看见的一切不过反映了我的观念。 All things I see reflect ideas. 我自以为看见的一切不过反映了我的观念。 All things I see reflect ideas.
练习手册第325课，我自以为看见的一切不过反映了我的观念。 Lesson 325 All things I see reflect ideas. 奇迹中文第25章圣主的正义 Chapter 25 The Justice of God. 9天堂的正义9. The Justice of Heaven.
你若认为天堂的正义都化解不了你那些小小过失，这不是傲慢还是什么？ What can it be but arrogance to think your little errors cannot be undone by Heaven's justice? 这表示他们不只是过错，而且还是永远修正不了的罪过，理当受到报应，不配以正义代之。And what could this mean except that they are sins and not mistakes, forever uncorrectable and to be met with vengeance, not with justice? 你真想摆脱罪的一切遗害吗？ Are you willing to be released from all effects of sin? 在你明白这答复所带来的一切后果以前，你是无法答复这个问题的。You cannot answer this until you see all that the answer must entail. 因你的答复若是肯定的，表示你已愿放下世上的一切价值，选择天堂的平安。For if you answer yes, it means you will forego all values of this world in favor of the peace of heaven. 也表示你不想保留任何一丝罪恶了。Not one thing would you retain. 表示你毫不怀疑自己，若能执迷于罪恶，罪就被你保存下来了。And not one doubt that this is possible while you hold dear that sin be kept in place. 同时，这也表示你开始重视真相超过一切幻想。You meant the truth has greater value now than all illusions.并且认清了自己对真相一无所知，明白自己需要真相的启迪。 And you recognize that truth must be revealed to you because you know not what it is. 心不甘情不愿的施予之人，自己是收不到礼物的，只因你不会甘心接受。 To give reluctantly is not to gain the gift because you are reluctant to accept it.这礼物只能等到你解除了不甘心态，而欢喜接受之际才会给你。 It is saved for you until reluctance to receive it disappears and you are willing it be given you. 上主的正义保证只让人感恩，不会令人恐惧。 God's justice warrants gratitude, not fear.你给出的一切，不论是自己或给他人的，都会被珍藏于天堂内，永不示弱。凡是献给上主之子的珍宝，上主都会为他妥善保存，等着转赠给甘心伸出手来接受礼物的人。 Nothing you give is lost to you or anyone, but cherished and preserved in heaven, where all of the treasures given to God's Son and kept for him and offered anyone who but holds out his hand in willingness, they are received.
这些珍宝不论给出多少都不会减少分毫。
Nor is the treasure less as it is given out.反而每给出一分就会增加一分。Each gift but adds to the supply. 上主是公平的 ,for God is fair.
他不会因为圣子不甘心接受他的救恩就处罚他迫他就范。
He does not fight against his son's reluctance to perceive salvation as a gift from him.
但是他的正义仍需等到所有人都接受下来才算功德圆满。
Yet would his justice not be satisfied until it is received by everyone?
我敢保证圣灵的方案永远带给人皆大欢喜的结局。
Be certain any answer to a problem the Holy Spirit solves will always be one in which no one loses.
这是千真万确的，因他从不要求任何人牺牲。
And this must be true because he asks no sacrifice of anyone.
任何解决方案只要有一方受到一点损失，不仅解决不了问题，还会雪上加霜，使问题变得更加严重，更为棘手，也更不公平。
And answer which demands the slightest loss to anyone has not resolved the problem, but has added to it.And made it greater, harder to resolve, and more unfair.
圣灵不可能给出不公平的解决方案的。
It is impossible the Holy Spirit could see unfairness as a resolution.
对他而言，不公平的事就是有待修正的事，只因他不公平。
To him, what is unfair must be corrected because it is unfair.
每个错误都代表了你认为有一方受到了不公平的待遇。
And every error is a perception in which one, at least, is seen unfairly.
换句话说，上主之子并未获得他应得的正义。
Thus is justice not accorded to the Son of God.
任何人在你眼中若成了失败者或受害者，那其实是你对他的一种诅咒。
When anyone is seen as losing, he has been condemned.
他命中好似注定要受惩罚而非正义的对待。
And punishment becomes his due instead of justice.
只要你能看到纯洁无罪的一面，便不可能惩罚任何人的，
只要代之以正义。The sight of innocence makes punishment impossible and justice sure.
圣灵的知见从不给人攻击的理由。
The Holy Spirit's perception leaves no ground for an attack.
只有受损才会给人攻击的借口，但他眼中根本没有损失这一回事。
Only a loss could justify attack and loss of any kind. He cannot see.
这世界企图以另一种方式解决问题。
The world solves problems in another way.
他的方案就是决定谁输谁赢，赢的一方应得到多少利益，输的一方又能包住几分本钱。
It sees a resolution as a state in which it is decided who shall win.And who shall lose, how much the one shall take, and how much can the loser still defend?
这根本解决不了任何问题，只有公正的方案才能带来双赢的局面，没有一方受到剥削或不公的待遇，因此也没有谁要报复谁的问题。
Yet,Does the problem still remain unsolved? For only justice can set up a state in which there is no loser, no one left unfairly treated and deprived, and thus with grounds for vengeance.
报复，绝非解决之道。他最多只会在旧问题上引发新的问题，借此隐藏他存心置人于死地的阴谋。
Problem solving cannot be vengeance, which at best can bring another problem added to the first, in which the murder is no obvious.
只有圣灵的方案才能真正解决问题。The Holy Spirit's problem solving is the way in which the problem ends. 正因为它绝对公正，问题才得以解决。It has been solved because it has been met with justice. 除非它还给人一个公道，否则问题必层出不穷。只因为问题根本就没有解决。
Until it has it will recur because it has not yet been solved.
正义意味没有任何一方会输着，一原则乃是本课程的要旨。
The principle that justice means no one can lose is crucial to this course.
因奇迹必须建立在正义的基础上 ,for miracles depend on justice. 这儿所说的正义绝非世界眼中的正义，而是上主所知的正义，也是圣灵赐给世界的会演说反映出来的真知真相。
Not as it is seen through this world's eyes, but as God knows it and as knowledge is reflected in the sight the Holy Spirit gives.
没有人会输或受损的。
No one deserves to lose.
不义之事根本不可能发生 and what would be unjust to him cannot occur. 每个人必会获得疗愈，因他本来就不该受到任何侵犯。
Healing must be for everyone because he does not merit an attack of any kind.
除非你认为某人应该多受一点苦，另一人则少受一点，否则奇迹岂会有难易之分。
What order can there be of miracles unless someone deserves to suffer more and others less?
这对全然纯洁无罪的人来讲，公正吗？
And is this justice to the holy innocent?
奇迹就是正义的表现。A miracle is justice. 它绝非只给某些人特殊礼物，其他人则不配得到，该多受一些惩罚或永不得疗愈。
It is not a special gift to some to be withheld from others as less worthy, more condemned, and thus apart from healing.
救恩既是为了终结特殊性，怎么可能把某人弃于救恩之外？
Who is there who can be separate from salvation if its purpose is the end of specialness?
如果有些错误是不可原谅的，该受天谴，不配接受疗愈或最终的平安，最终救恩公平吗？
Where is salvation justice if some errors are unforgivable and warrant vengeance in place of healing and return of peace?
救恩怎么可能落井下石，害那心存不公的圣子变得更加不义？
Salvation cannot seek to help God's son be more unfair than he has sought to be.
如果圣灵的奇迹之伤给某个被拣选者或特定的团体，其他人都不配得到，表示他已和特殊性同流合污了。
If miracles, the Holy Spirit's gift, were given specially to an elect and special group and kept apart from others as less deserving, then is he allied to specialness?
那他怎么可能为自己视而不见之物作证？
What he cannot perceive, he bears no witness to.
每个人都有同等权利接受上主的疗愈、救恩及平安的礼物。
And everyone is equally entitled to his gift of healing and deliverance and peace.
心甘情愿地把问题交给圣灵去解决，才表示你真的想要解决这一问题。
To give a problem to the Holy Spirit to solve for you means that you want it solved.
你若不求助于他，而企图自行解决，便表示你根本存心不想解决问题，宁可任由不义与攻击肆虐下去。 To keep it for yourself to solve without his help is to decide it should remain unsettled, unresolved, and lasting in its power of injustice and attack.
没有人能待你不公，除非你自己先存不义之心。
No one can be unjust to you unless you have decided first to be unjust.
倘若如此，许多问题便会随之冒出。阻挠你前行，你的平安就被怨恨之气远远驱离了。
And then must problems rise to block your way, and peace be scattered by the winds of hate.
除非你认为所有的弟兄都同你一样有权拥有奇迹，否则你便丧失了奇迹的权利，只因你没有公正对人一视同仁。
Unless you think that all your brothers have an equal right to miracles with you, you will not claim your right to them because you were unjust to one with equal right.
你若有意拒绝一个人，就会感到自己也被人拒绝。
Seek to deny and you will feel denied.
你若存心剥削一个人，你也必会感到被人剥削。
Seek to deprive and you have been deprived.
如果别人无法获得奇迹，你也绝对得不到奇迹。
A miracle can never be received because another could receive it not.
只有宽恕能给人奇迹。
Only forgiveness offers miracles.
你的宽恕必须对所有的人都一视同仁。
And pardon must be just.To everyone,
你若还想隐藏任何一个小问题，它都会变成你不可告人的罪，因为是你决心不让此罪消除的。
The little problems that you keep and hide become your secret sins, because you did not choose to let them be removed for you.
它就会堆积成垢，逐渐做大，大到足以遮蔽你的所知所见，使你再也无法公允地看待任何一人。
And so they gather dust and grow until they cover everything that you perceive and leave you fear to no one.
也不会相信自己享有任何的权利。
Not one right do you believe you have.
你的内心的怨恨给了你报复的借口，驱逐了你的慈悲心，使你更加认为自己不配接受宽恕。
And bitterness with vengeance justified and mercy lost condemns you as unworthy of forgiveness.
未受宽恕的人是不可能慈悲待人的。
Thus, unforgiven have no mercy to bestow upon other.
为此之故，你唯一的责任就是先让自己接受宽恕。
That is why your sole responsibility must be to take forgiveness for yourself.
你接受什么奇迹，就会给出什么奇迹。
The miracle that you receive, you give.
若想疗愈任何一人，必先公正对待所有的人。每个奇迹都成了这一救恩法则的最佳范本。
Each one becomes an illustration of the law on which salvation rests. The justice must be done to all if anyone is to be healed.
没有人会输或受损，所有的人都领受得到奇迹智慧。
No one can lose and everyone must benefit.
每个奇迹都为你示范了所有的人都获得正义之后的自然结果。
Each miracle is an example of what justice can accomplish when it is offered to everyone alike.
奇迹的是与受是平等互惠的。
It is received and given equally.
因奇迹本身就是对施与受原是同一回事的一种领悟。
It is awareness that giving and receiving are the same.
它既不会把相同之物视为相异，也不会在毫无 不同之处，看出差异。Because it does not make the same unlike. It sees no differences where none exist. 他对所有的人一视同仁，因为他在众人身上看不到任何不同。And thus it is the same for everyone because it sees no differences in them. 奇迹是大公无私的，他只教一个人讯息。It's offering is universal and it teaches but one message. 上主所有的一切属于每一个人呢，是他的天赋权利。What is God's belongs to everyone and is his due.
奇迹中文第25章上主的正义 Chapter 25 The Justice of God 9天堂的正义 9 The Justice of Heaven
愿大家有一个生命充满的一天阿们我爱你哦